Hello everyone, this is Suyog Patil, Assistant Professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, SIT COE at RAU. Today we are going to see the design of single plate clutch. Clutch is a mechanism which enables the rotary motion of one shaft to be transmitted when desired to a second shaft, the axis of which is coincident. That means the clutches are basically used to transmit power from one shaft, that is driver shaft, to the another driven shaft, to engage or disengage this driver and driven shaft without stopping the prime mover. These clutches are basically used. The function of the clutch is again similar to the function of the coupling. Coupling is a device which is used to connect two shafts together for the purpose of transmitting power. But the basic difference between this coupling and clutch is the coupling is a rigid member or permanent connected member, but and clutch is a temporary connected member. Then again, according to the service type, this clutch is intermittent service is provided, but in case of this coupling, this continuous service is there. That means this coupling provides continuously power transmission. Then according to this shaft, clutches are connected with collinear shafts, and the coupling is with collinear as well as or non-collinear shafts. Speed variation. This speed variation, we can vary the speed with the help of these clutches. But in case of this coupling, driver speed will remain same as the driven speed. This is the basic difference between this coupling and clutch. Now, functions of this clutch. To permit the engagement or disengagement of a gear when the vehicle is stationary and the engine is running. Whenever we want to transmit this power from engine to the vehicle without stopping this engine, to engage and disengage and to transmit the power, this clutch is required. To transmit the engine power to the road wheels smoothly without shock to the transmission system while the vehicle is in motion. In order to engage and disengage without any shock and smooth power transmission system, these clutches are required. To transmit the engaging of the gears when the vehicle is in motion without damaging the gear wheels. Again, this is the primary functions of these clutches. Now, the requirement of the clutch. Here, I have listed few requirements of this clutch. First one, it is torque transmission. This clutch should transmit the maximum torque. This is the prime requirement. Then gradual engagement. Without the occurrence of the sudden jerks, this clutch should be engaged and disengaged gradually. Heat dissipation. Adequate dissipation of the heat should be there. Okay, this is also one of the requirement of the clutch. Then dynamic balancing is necessary, particularly in high speed clutches. Then to eliminate noise produced in the transmission system, vibration damping is also required. Okay. Then this minimum size, the clutch must be as smallest as possible. The size of the clutch is as small as possible. Okay. Then again, minimum inertia should be there. Then ace of the operation should be there. These are the prime requirement of the clutch. Now we will see the classification of this clutch. Clutch is basically classified into two main groups, that is positive clutch and gradual engagement clutch. Okay, so example of this positive clutch is dog clutch, as we discussed in the previous lectures. Then in gradual engagement clutch, friction clutch, fluid flywheels are there. Again, this friction clutch is classified into different categories according to the size and shape of this clutch. Disc or plate clutch, then second clone clutch, semi-centrifugal clutch and centrifugal clutch. Okay, so again, this disc and or plate clutch is classified into two main categories, that is single plate clutch and multi-plate clutch. This single plate clutch is used normally where space problem is not there. Okay, for example, in jeeps and trucks there is no limitation of the space, so we can use this type of this clutch. Multi-plate clutch is basically used where the space problem is there, space limitation is there. For example, in automobiles, two-wheelers, this multiplate type of the clutch is basically used. Then again, this cone clutch is divided into two categories, internal and external. Then centrifugal clutch. Centrifugal clutch is basically used where load is not defined. For example, in washing machine, where load varies from zero to a certain higher limit of the load. In such a cases, this centrifugal type of the clutches are used. Okay, this is about the classification of the clutch. Now we will see the design of the single plate clutch. Now here, a clutch enables two coaxial shafts to be engaged or disengaged while at rest or in relative motion. Now we can see here in this figure number 11.2, one driving shaft is there and one driven shaft is there. Okay, on which this driving shaft, there are two pressure plates. This is one of the pressure plate and this is another pressure plate. Okay, one is mounted on this driving shaft and second one it is mounted on the driven shaft. Driven shaft is generally spline shaft. Okay, in order to move this pressure plate on the driven shaft, these splines are provided. Then again, one friction plate is mounted on this driven shaft. Okay, so again here we can see the friction lining material is provided for the friction, or in order to get this frictional force and to transmit the power from driving shaft to the driven shaft, this frictional lining material is provided. Okay, again we can see this is the case here shown is the disengaged position of the clutch plate, and this case here shown is the engaged condition. Now when this clutch is in engaged position, this power is transmitted from this driven shaft to this pressure plate. Then again this power is transmitted with the help of this frictional force from this pressure plate to the friction plate, and again finally this friction plate to the pressure plate which is mounted on the driven shaft, and finally it is transmitted to the driven shaft. So this power transmission is done with this help of friction force. Okay, this is the construction and working of the single plate clutch. Now while designing this single plate clutch, we have to calculate the torque transmission capacity and power transmission capacity of the clutch. Now in order to calculate this power, as we know, the power is equals to 2 pi n t divided by 60, where t is the torque. Now therefore we have to calculate first of all torque, but again as we know this torque is equals to force into perpendicular distance. Okay, so therefore we have to calculate the force, that is the frictional force generated in this frictional area. Okay, now we are going to calculate this frictional force generated in this frictional surface area. Okay, now in order to calculate this frictional force, we will consider a small elemental ring here, okay, whose radius is small r and thickness is small dr. So therefore the area of this elemental ring is here 2 pi r into dr. Okay, now this elemental axial force which is acting on this elemental surface is, as we know, the pressure is equals to force per unit area. So therefore force is equals to pressure into area. So this elemental axial force is equals to P into 2 pi r into dr. Okay, which is equals to 2 pi P into r into dr. Now this is the elemental axial force. Now elemental frictional force acting on this pressure acting on this ring is. So this elemental frictional force is equals to mu into P into 2 pi r into dr, where mu is the coefficient of friction. Now when we get this elemental frictional force, now we have to calculate the elemental frictional torque, okay, due to this frictional force. So the torque transmitted by this elemental area, surface area, is torque is equals to force into perpendicular distance, that is mu into P into 2 pi r dr into this small radius r, okay, perpendicular distance. So therefore now here we got elemental frictional torque is equals to 2 pi mu into P r square into dr, okay. Now by integrating this equation A and equation B, we can calculate the frictional force and the torque transmitted by this clutch, okay. Now we can see here this clutch plate is varying from this point to this point, and again it is from this to this. That means it is varying from small d by 2, here we can say small d by 2, as well as here we can say capital D by 2. So therefore we have to integrate this equation from small d by 2 to capital D by 2. So therefore we will get this expression for frictional force P is equals to 2 pi in integration of small d by 2 to capital D by 2 PR into dr. Similarly we will get the equation for this pressure is MT is equals to 2 pi mu integration small d by 2 to capital D by 2 PR square into dr, okay. Then while integrating these two equations, we have to consider these basic two theories. One it is called as uniform pressure theory, and second one it is called as uniform wear theory. When the clutches are new clutches employing number of springs, the pressure remains constant. In that case, when the clutches are new, so we will go for this uniform pressure theory. And according to this uniform pressure theory, by considering this pressure is constant, we can calculate by integrating the previous two equations, operating, we can calculate operating force as well as we can calculate the torque transmitted. So therefore we will get this equation P is equals to pi into P by 4 into capital D square minus small d square. Similarly we will get the equation of the torque MT is equals to mu into P divided by 3 into in bracket capital D cube minus small d cube divided by capital D square minus small d square, okay. Similarly in the same way we can calculate this operating force as well as torque by uniform wear theory as well. This uniform wear theory is used when the friction lining gets wear out. So according to this theory we will get this operating force P is equals to pi into PA into small d divided by 2 into in bracket capital D minus small d, and torque transmitted is equals to MT is equals to mu into P divided by 4 into in bracket capital D plus small d, okay. Now again for more clarification we can refer this design of machine elements by VB Bhandari third edition page number 451 for the more clarification of these equations, okay. Now this is what about the design of the single plate clutch. That means we have to calculate the power transmission capacity and torque transmission capacity. Now we will see one simple numerical based on this single plate clutch. A plate clutch consists of a pair of contacting surfaces. The inner and outer diameters of the friction disc are 100 mm and 200 mm respectively. That means capital D is and small d are given 200 and 100 mm respectively. Then the coefficient of friction is 0.2, that means mu is equals to 0.2 it is given, and permissible intensity of pressure is 1 newton per mm square, That means small Pa is equals to 1 Newton per mm square, it is given. Then, assuming uniform wear theory, calculate the power transmission capacity of the clutch at 750 rpm. That is, speed of this clutch is given, n is equals to, small n is equals to 750 rpm. Okay, now we will solve this numerical by both the theories, that is uniform wear theory as well as uniform pressure theory. Then according to this uniform wear theory, as we know, this operating force is equals to P is equals to pi into Pa into small d divided by 2 into in bracket capital D minus small d. Okay, now here small d, capital D and uniform pressure Pa is also given. So by putting all these values here in this equation, we will get this value of the operating force P. So this operating force P is equals to 15707.96 Newton. Okay, now similarly, next step is to calculate the power transmission capacity. Well, calculate this power transmission capacity. Power is equals to 2 pi n mt divided by 60. So first of all, we have to calculate the torque transmitted by this clutch. So therefore, torque transmitted by this clutch according to the uniform wear theory is mt is equals to mu p divided by 4 into in bracket capital D plus small d. Again, by putting all these values, we will get this value of mt here. Mt is equals to 235619.4 Newton mm. Okay, this is the torque transmitted by the clutch. Now once we get this torque transmitted, we can calculate the power. Power in kilowatt is equals to 2 pi n mt divided by 60 into 10 raised to 6. So therefore, again by putting this value of the n, small n, mt, so again we will get this value of the power transmission capacity, and it is kilowatt, 18.51 kilowatt, according to this uniform wear theory. Similarly, we can calculate this operating force and power transmission capacity by uniform pressure theory as well. Now in uniform, according to this uniform pressure theory, the operating force P is equals to pi into P by 4 into in bracket capital D square minus small d square. Again, by putting all these values here, we will get this value of P, that is 23561.95 Newton. That is the operating force. Now next we have to calculate this torque. Torque mt is equals to, according to uniform pressure theory, mu into P divided by 3 into in bracket capital D cube minus small d cube divided by capital D square minus small d square. So by again putting these values, we will get here this value of mt. This, it is equals to 366519.22 Newton mm. Okay, similarly we will get the value of the power. Power transmitted is equals to kilowatt is equals to 2 pi n mt upon 60 into 10 raised to 6. So putting again values, we will get this power is equals to 28.79 kilowatt. Okay, so according to uniform pressure theory as well as uniform wear theory, we will get these values of the power transmitted capacity of the clutch. Okay, this is all about the design of single plate clutch. Thank you so much.